Hello and welcome back to Ganesh Institute channel. So in today's video we are going to discuss about a few things like firstly how to solve a quadratic equation using quadratic formula and what are the nature of roots or zeros which we get by solving the quadratic equations. So let's begin with our discussion with the help of an example. If you see here, you have to find out the nature of the roots. And if the roots exist, we have to find them also. So what does it mean? First of all, let's say you have a standard equation in the form of ax square plus bx plus c equals 0. So this is your standard equation. Now, in order to apply quadratic formula to solve these equations, you have to find out the discriminant. The value of discriminant is or can be found out by this formula b square minus 4ac. Now, once you find out d, then you can get the nature of roots. Let's say the value of d is 0. Then you can say that there are two roots, but these are equal. So we have equal roots in case of d as 0. You know very well that we have those as many number of roots as the degree itself. So because the quadratic equation have degree 2, so therefore there will be equal roots, two equal roots, right? Thereafter, if d is greater than 0, then we have two roots, but they are distinct. They are real but distinct. That means different. We have real and equal roots here. Real means they can be rational or irrational. And if d is negative, less than 0, then we will not be having any real roots. Okay? No real roots. So let's see. If you compare this with the standard form, what is a here? 3. What is b? Minus 4 root 3. And what is c? 4. Right? With x square, we have a. We have b here and c, correct? So d will be b square minus 4ac, that means minus 4 root 3 whole square minus 4ac, correct? Now minus square is plus, 4 fours are 16, root 3 into root 3 is 3, so 48 minus 40s are 12, 4s are 48. You have d as 0, so that means you have two roots but both of them are equal. So how you will find them? If you will find out that d is 0 or greater than 0, then you can get your result by using x as minus b plus minus root d by 2a. So your value is minus b. That means minus minus plus 4 root 3 plus minus root d, which is 0. So nothing is required here. 2a. So that means your both of the roots are 4 root 3 by 6, 4 root 3 by 6. 2 to the 4, 2 3 are 6, 2 to the 4, 2 3 are 6. Correct? Let's take up another example. Okay? So in this question, you have to find the values of k so that they have equal roots. So the condition is this. First of all, convert this equation into quadratic equation form. How? By expanding it. So kx square minus 2kx plus 6 equals 0. Now, if roots are equal, which is the condition given in the question, that means d will be 0. D is what? Discriminant in the quadratic formula. So now, if we compare this with standard quadratic equation form, which is this, you will find that with x square, it is a here. Here, it is k. So, a is k. Correct? Now, if you see the coefficient of x, it is b, whereas here the coefficient of x is minus 2k, and the constant term is c, so constant term here is 6. Now for equal roots we have d as 0, and what is the formula for d? It is b square minus 4ac, correct? So what is b? It is minus 2k square, that means 4k square minus 4ac. So, it will become 6 4s are 24k
equals 0. You can take, see, don't solve this like this, 4k square is equals to 24k, k will be cancelled, k is 6. Because it is also a quadratic equation and it should have two roots, correct? And to attain two roots, here we are able to find only one, correct? So how you have to solve it? Take common 4k, what is left? 4, 6 are 24, so k minus 6. One time 4k equals 0, so k is 0. And on the other hand, k is equal to 6, so these are two values of k. So in this way, you can solve these sort of questions where the conditions are given and you have to find out the value of a particular constant. Now let's take up another example. Here you need to check this out, whether particular situation is possible or not. How? Let's see. Is it possible to design a rectangular mango groove whose length is twice its breadth? So let's say length is, let length be x. So x units, it is written meter square, so that means x meter. Now what is given? Length is twice its breadth, so we have to consider breadth here, right? So breadth is x, so length will be what? Twice its breadth, that means 2x meter. Now area is what? 800 meter square, it is given to us, correct? Usually when you have a rectangular shape, what is the formula? Length into breadth. What is length? 2x. What is breadth? X, 800. 2x square is equals to 800. X square is equals to 400, correct? So what will be the value of x here? You know very well that there should be two roots, right? Positive and one is negative. But you cannot consider negative root because there are length and breadth. So if you solve it, so if you see, it is 4 into 100. If you take the square root, so you will have 2 from 4 and 10 from 100. So x will be 20, correct? It can be plus 20, minus 20. We cannot consider minus 20 because sides cannot be negative. So this is your breadth, which is 20 meter. And this is 2 into 20, that means 40 meter is your what length. Now, yes, it is possible because here if you see, area is given to you, right? Twice its breadth. Because d is positive, if you see here, the quadratic equation is in which form? X square minus 400, correct? So that means if you consider this and compare it with standard form, which is ax square plus bx plus c equals 0, you will find that a is 1 here, x is not here, so b is 0, and c is what? Minus 400, correct? So if you find out d, which is b square minus 4ac, so b is what? 0 square minus 4ac. So your d is what? 1600. Because d is greater than 0, so that means roots are possible. And what's the nature of roots? Real and distinct. So then we can solve it further like this. So it is possible. So whenever you have, you will have certain type of questions where you need to check the possibility. So what you will do, just find out the quadratic equation, make a quadratic equation out of the statement, and then find out D. If it is real and distinct or real and equal, then you can go ahead with the question. I hope the concept is clear, and if so, then don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. Till my next video, take care of yourself. Bye-bye.